two people killed, including a teenager, on an icy road in Butler County. And tonight we found out a woman called 911 hours before that crash, warning deputies about the problem. News5's Karin Johnson is live with the exclusive. Karin.
Well, Jack, that woman came to News 5 wanting answers. She says, and records show, she called and reported an ice patch 14 hours before the deadly accident. So why wasn't that spot treated?
When I first heard about it, I got goosebumps all over me, and I just wanted to cry.
Kim Murdy says she was shocked when she heard about Wednesday's car accident on Oxburger Road, reportedly caused by a slick spot. It's the one that killed 18-year-old Wade Young and 68-year-old Charlena Hornsby and injured three other teens.
We even went back out there to make sure, to see if it was the same place.
Kim says she witnessed another wreck in the same spot earlier that morning. She even made this 911 call.
I got a call from Camp Campbell Guard. A truck, I guess, hit a patch of ice and then circles and went into the field. Well, some ice on the road and started doing circles and ended up like the road.
And I just think that maybe if somebody would have went out there and done something about the ice and the road, that maybe the people wouldn't have had to die.
We checked into it. Records from the engineer's office show it was never notified. However, Kim's 911 call was acknowledged by dispatchers who sent a deputy.
He drove the entire length of the roadway, and he's going to be looking for any kind of slick spots also when he does that. He just didn't find any.
Chief DeWire says in the 14 hours that passed between Kim's 911 call and the fatal accident, no one else reported any slick spots on this stretch of road.
There's a lot of cars that would have been traveling that roadway during the time. It's a good chance that that warmed up and melted off and then refroze later in the evening. I just don't know.
So obviously, if you are out driving and notice any dangerous or icy spots, you still are encouraged to call police. Now, since the deadly accident, the engineer's office has been out. They did dig a ditch, so the water running off the hill alongside the road now hopefully goes into the ditch instead of onto the road. Reporting live tonight in Butler County, Karin Johnson, News 5.